Hello, Serge here from the Backyard Driving Range. We have a question, came into the website from Robert Burchett. And he says, "Hello, Serge. I have worked hard to improve my driver play with a lighter weight 45-inch driver. I've used a somewhat lowered right shoulder, I'm right-handed, and a sweeping upward swing through the hitting area. The problem is that this ascending swing doesn't work very well with my full iron shots, which require a more descending hit and a divot. Because my drives are so much improved, I believe that subconsciously my driver swing is creeping into my iron swing, causing mishits, usually sculled to the right. Is there a drill or something that would groove me out of this? I enjoy your daily tips, Serge, and I appreciate what you are doing for golf." Okay, Bob Burchett, Davenport, Iowa. So I guess you haven't been able to play much golf for a while up there in Davenport, probably with the winter being cold up there. But let's talk about the difference between what could be happening here. All right, first off, I like to say that I try to make the same swing with all clubs. And it's naturally, the ball position changes. We like to play wedges through the seven in the middle, and as we get to the driver, it moves up to about the left heel or just back of the left heel. All right, now, by making the same swing, I'm saying that with every club, I try to take the club into the catcher's mitt, toe up, lift the arms up the tree, so that when I get into the catcher's mitt, which is my aiming line out here, up the tree, the forward arm is over the toe line, the club is vertical, a light club, it'll fall straight down, then swing through up to the tee finish. And again, from this view, that would look like the tee finish here, hands close to the head, palms perpendicular to the ground, recoil and relax at the target. I try to make the same swing. Now, normally my first practice swing is always exactly with the club and the shot and the swing I need for the shot I've decided I want to hit. And the biggest thing I'm doing is I'm practicing. I know for me, I'm never going to go past three quarters. That's so built into my DNA, the DNA of my golf swing, that's not going to happen. But the thing that has to be important, and like just right here in his backyard, I have to work with, is that I'm slightly downhill here. So I'm always making a practice swing to make sure and feel getting to my finish, recoil, and relax. And when I feel that swing, and I can feel, I think hopefully y'all heard that, even with a fairly relaxed swing, I'm not swinging really hard at my full bore, but I have a good solid grip and I'm making a good swing. What I'm trying to feel is getting to my finish and what's happening with my swing through here. So that in the case of a side hill lie or whatever, or a downhill uphill lie, I want to know that and feel that I'm going to get the impact before the hill or something might push me off. And if it's just a dead flat lie, I'm just locking in, boom. I'm locking in my swing into my finishing here. Because basically I base every swing, and I think the success of the swing is getting to a good finish. If you get to a good dynamically balanced finish every time, you should be able to make, you'll be making good swings and you should be hitting good shots. And so the key is if you can't get to a good finish every time, then there's a problem there. So I would have to say that based on what you said about you feeling that your driver swing, Bob, is probably creeping into your iron swing, and you're hitting better drivers than irons, then I would have to think your driver swing must have a pretty good balanced finish, whereas you're having a problem getting there with your irons. So I'm going to suspect that for starters, A, always check alignment first, right? Alignment, don't play golf without it. 90 to 95% of all swing problems arise out of alignment. But what could be happening is you might have your alignment could be both good with both of them, and sometimes proper alignment, say you're dead perfectly square in your alignment, but if your ball position is off, now you've got an indirect alignment issue, meaning if the ball is too far forward, and so consequently you're somewhat behind it now, you are effectively returning the ball back to impact, you're hitting it after, I should have been making impact here, I'm making it there, look where the club is. It's already released, it's slightly closed, and the ball would very likely go dead left, and or I could be coming out of the shot and actually topping it. And to stop all of those things, I start opening up my hands. I'm technically into a slight reverse weight shift. I could start hitting everything else that way and even coming back here and topping it. So I could stand here and hit it dead left. I could come out of the shot and top it, right? I could actually release the shot, and I could actually hit it far enough left over here where I'd miss the net, but I don't want to hit it over there. There's things in the yard there. And so, or I could actually, if the balls are too far up there, I could come down and bounce it off the ground for us. And in that case, it went right. Conversely, if the ball position was back too far, now I'm going to be too far ahead of the ball, so to speak, and the ball position is back too far, so if I come into impact from there, I'm going to have too steep a descending blow, and I could be actually, if I hit the ball, I could be hitting and basically almost sticking the club in the ground. Now, you know that in a surge swing, we always talk about we want to take shallow divots. We want the club to ricochet off the ground. That's why I love hitting off a mat, so I can just stand here and just I can just feel that club just zip off, just skip right off the mat. Boom. Because if you start hitting down too hard on these things, they can actually hurt you, just like the ground. So we want the ball, we want thin divots. Thin to win's our motto. So we don't even think about hitting down. We think about swinging up, and swinging up works. Because why? If you're up here, you have to go down to hit the ball first. But down is free, right? The club will just drop straight down. But everything after the ball is not free. So as long as you have that thought process in your mind that you want to nip it off the ground, you want to hit those like touch and go impacts, the ball position is critical, because again, like I said, getting back to back. So if you're here and you're hitting down too much, then you could be doing what? You could be getting so far ahead of the ball that you could come in here and the club definitely doesn't have time to release the square. So where's it gonna go? It's gonna go right and anywhere from low to if you've been, you know, trying to get it and try to help it up, maybe you start opening up the face, it could start right and slice right after that. Or you try to come backwards to hit the ball. And so if you start coming back to it, you'd be falling back to the back foot, and you see a lot of people when they stomp back like this, that's either ball position or aiming for right hand or too far to the right. So ball position is critical. So we play wedges to the seven in the middle, and then the ball gradually looks a little forward for the club we have, and as the ball goes forward or you go back, your hands move from being pointed to hanging in the center, there's forward, but they will return to center in your swing because the club will be releasing and getting to the ball. All right? So hopefully this explains everything, and I definitely got a feeling it's probably ball position in this instant. And if the ball's too far forward or back, you know you've just heard what is going to be those big issues. So when you get that ball position correct, you just stand in here and bingo. Well, that was a rocket coming back, hit the top of the fence. That's it for the search for today on both swings are the same, just change ball position, but I'm trying to make the same swing, and especially with the irons, we're nipping it off the ground. Okay, well that's it, and I'll be talking to y'all again soon.